Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the program. My name is Sumaya Hussain and this is Show Me the Market, a business-oriented show tailored to show you how ordinary businesses are brought to life. Today we're here in South Sea and we're going to visit Madina Butchery, where we'll meet Farhan and he'll tell us all the ups and downs of running a butchery business. Thank you so much for inviting us to your butchery. Do you mind telling me what influenced you to start it?
What influenced me was quite a lot. These are the photographs of my father. My grandfather actually came from Pakistan in the 1920s and he started the butchery business in Kenya. So whatever we are because of him today.
So when exactly did you start this one here?
This one I started in 2010, September. Been 10 years so far, so good.
What was the startup cost for this butchery specifically?
The investment cost, you're looking over maybe this size butchery right now. If you were to do it, about 15 million.
So the 15 million that was capital, what are some of the things you used to acquire?
We have the mincer, slicer, bone saw. Then I've got two cold rooms at the back. The counters, these are expensive if you go for the good ones. They also display the meat and they also keep them cold during the whole day.
Could you tell us what are some of the daily expenses you incur here?
Daily expenses for me to keep this shop running, I'll need to make a profit about 17,000 shillings per day. So you do the math.
How much do you use to acquire the meat on a daily basis?
You could say goat meat for about 50K. Then we have beef, which we get like maybe twice or thrice a week. You get one lot of beef, you're looking at 200K. Chicken, we get about 60,000-70,000 from Kenchik every day.
And would you mind telling us some of the factors that affect the pricing of each type of meat?
Now the chicken, with the chicken we work on a percentage of 20-25% because of our expenses are high. We have cold room, we have 7 staff to pay. The expenses are high. So we work on a 25% profit margin. Yes, 20-25%.
Other factors such as taxation, transport costs. Currently we're looking at inflation. So has that in any way affected your business?
When we talk about cost of living going up, it has gone up for everybody. It's not only the supermarket, it's not only Madina Butchery, it's not any other butchery, it's for everybody. Like the person I used to get maybe coming once a week to buy maybe goods worth 10-15,000, I could see him after 2 weeks now.
If I take a walk around South Sea right now, yeah. I can point out quite a number of other butcheries that are also operating. So how would you say you stay ahead of competition?
I would say that, you know, there are a few butcheries which I can compare to my standards of running a butchery. We have cold rooms, we have trained staff, and then also the quality of meat. Now we look at the other butcheries. They are small, their expenses are low, they sell 2 goats, they're happy for the day. But us guys, we have to sell more than 15 goats to break even.
When you say you have trained staff, what do you mean by that? Who trains them?
We have Francis here. He's been working in the meat industry for 15 years. We have Anthony there. He's been working for 20 years. I had a few other guys. They have left. We have Esau. I trained him from the day we opened this butchery, 10 years now. We have Harrison, we have Kelvin, we have Nicodemus there. They are all trained butchers. You tell them that you want the meat to be cleaned properly, they will clean it for you. Now, which other butcheries don't do? I also fight with them all the time. Why are you wasting so much time cleaning the meat? You should go and cook for them as well. So that is how we operate. We make the customer happy in whatever way we can. And as I told you, I follow my mother's policy, only sell what you can eat.
How would you say you market and advertise your butchery?
The first thing I would rely on is word of mouth. Make one customer happy, he goes and tells 40. Annoy one customer, he goes and tells 100. Now the thing with me, I have built my name. I also do aged beef. Over the years, I have learned a lot as well here. I do use social media, Instagram and Facebook as well to market. Besides that, it just to wait for the customer and see how it goes.
Do you have special offers during different periods like Ramadan, for example?
The way the economy is right now, if someone wants to buy 2 chicken, he's only going to buy 2 chicken. So I'm the one at loss.
What are some of the challenges around the business?
in South Sea, if you look at every estate, every person wants to become a butcher right now. Every estate has a shop, which has a butchery, supermarket, and vegetable shop. Thanks to the county government, we're in this crisis right now. The licenses we pay, the taxes we pay, is not the same what these other small guys are going to pay.
Do you have any future plans for expanding your business?
You know, in the butchery business, you have to set yourself. It's not something like a supermarket where you have 10 packets of flour that you're going to come in the evening, you minus 3 and you're left with 7. With the butchery, every carcass has its different costing. Like, for example, one leg of hind quarter of a gombe might be having more waste compared to the other. So you need to be there throughout yourself as well.
And how do you manage your waste?
Waste, we have at the back of the shop, we have two guys who are there, who are actually just trimming the cutoffs, the trimmings and all that. And then some of it is sold as pet food and majority of it is thrown away. Yes.
So what would you say to someone else who wants to start a butchery as well?
I would say stick to the trade, you know. Honestly, stick to the trade, you know. It's not easy. It's not for everyone, exactly. As I told you, to run a butchery like this, if I order 15 goats, I've sold 15. But inside in the evening when I go to the cold room, I might find that I've got 15 saddles, which is the chops, the neck, the brisket. It's still remaining. What do you do with that? What are the small butcheries going to do with that? So it's a very tricky business. All businesses have their challenges.
We've come to the end of the program. Thank you so much for staying with us. I hope you learned a lot from Farhan on how to manage a successful business despite all the challenges that come with it. If you have any feedback, comments, questions, be sure to reach us on our social media platforms. Thank you so much for my crew for making this happen, and thank you for staying with us. My name is Sumaya Hussain. See you next time.